3. So for now, he'll stick around for a little bit longer, but long term, he's got his backup plan of farming up some of these neutral creeps. But we kind of spent a lot of time deliberating over who's going to be offlane. Is it going to be the Axe or the Doom? And really, has his first blood down mid, thanks to like multiple Earth Shocks just spammed out. Chakra Magic really helps for this as well. Involved in the lane, it's not as bad as like a TA or a Morphling, but it's enough for a Miracle to exploit.
Once you decide to commit to a right click as an OD, then usually the enemy's going to get close enough. Top lane, Call is there with neutrals attacking in. Axe caught the Terror Blade, and apparently Liquid aren't happy with that one. But yeah, Axe, all that much from Mank score. Two deaths, one assist over towards the mid lane, I believe, on Nursa. No, it was for someone else. But either way, not really doing a hell of a lot. Shotch, though, is going to catch the Terror Blade in a taunt right now. There is a Sunder, going to get him a lot of juice back, but he has two heroes on his tail, including Scorched Earth and the Blade. So Matoman's going to take a lot of non-physical damage. Bulba can only help him much here, but the Juke's to the south. Matoman's going to get a lot of distance away from Shotch, though, and Vangscore can't do it by himself, but they'll lose Bulba. Got hit by like a random spin there from the Axe. Pretty lucky for Shotch to get hit with that like one proc. And Tame Out Wild's going to circle in from behind, and that should pop the Terror Blade.
Yeah, so really good Sunder, really good Juke with the Quelling Blade, but unfortunately when TMW comes to play, there's really nothing you can
do. All their ultimates, in fact. Juggernaut doesn't have a... Actually, he has a little bit extra mana there. He must have gotten an Essence Aura off of the Healing Ward or something like that. But either way, they're going to drop the Chaotic Offering onto two in the backline. Pseudo immediately Omnislashing Bulba. We'll jump over to the creeps. Not the best there. Bulba will get a lot of distance away. The Nyx Assassin will pop out. He's doomed up as well, actually, and he will get brought down. Vangscore is still going in for the Shadow Demon. There is a disruption here. Shockwave's
gonna... He should be able to get a pickup on just one hero. It looks like Nyx and him can combo up to bring in either Vangscore or Sadoi. Just seems... Question is, which opportunity will present itself, and it seems like it is going to be Sadoi.
He doesn't have any allies here. Even if he did have some allies here, they don't have their big ultimates. Axe coming in. He doesn't have a Blink Dagger, though. Roger, he doesn't have any mana. Sidoi, though, is pretty quick with the Phase Boots, and he is not going to die to that combo. Mind Control, hit with the Infernal Blade, is going to spike Carapace to get himself a little bit of extra space. Turn around for an Impale will completely whiff, as will Kuroki's Illuminate. Mind Control is not going to get dunked, but he still will go down. And that's kind of the downside of going Max Earthshock, not going for more overpower, more...
Too, where Flipside have all the keys to the game. They have the tools for initiation in Shotchlo. They have all these things, but they just have to pick the right battles, and that might present itself bottom.
Sidoi, first of all, it's the Chaotic Offering onto three heroes. Shotchlo is there with the call onto the Ursa. He did get his ultimate off, so he's not taking that much damage from this Juggernaut, as they're all going to hit with the Illuminate. Juggernaut still has the Omni Slash, but there's not that much control here. Vangscore going to chase in. Invertiblade onto Bulba, slowest hero here, and they will dunk him. Just for good measure, he is down. That is a Warlock ultimate for a Shadow Demon kill, though. There is a bubble to disrupt it. Vangscore is going to come in from the side, try to disrupt as well, but the Axe is just going to blink on out of there. Easy peasy. He's going to run straight into Matumba Man. That's not what he wants to see. Will call once again to get himself a little bit more armor. He's just not dying. Ursa will take out the Warlock in the meantime, but Shotch, though, the target, is the one to slip away. And flip side, they lose a hero that is kind of useless for them anyway right now, since he doesn't have his ultimate. But still, Liquid, they call that a win. They have a lot of men more
HP. He's just way too low. He goes in, he dies with that one call. But there is a healing ward coming out from Sadoi, which will bring him back up to full very quickly. They're going to be going in with the spin. He's going to just be setting up a perfect call from Shashlo.
Oh, the Roshan, though, gets the last on the Nyx because so many units were near him. He just slams the ground.
Start to see things break relatively evenly. But flip side, are able to bring the Axe back in thanks to the healing ward of the Juggernaut, which has been skilled up pretty nicely at level 3 now, and that means that they're able to get in, to get the beautiful call combined with the ODLD and turn that entirely. So now big Aegis for the Juggernaut, and now they're even going to kill off the Nyx.
Doom and a call beforehand. He's going to get saved for a couple seconds, but he's just going to get spun down. And now the Chaotic Offering is going to connect onto three heroes. They're going to try to body block Matumba Man. Sidoi does not have his Omni Slash for this one, but they do have another call from Shotcho, catching two Sunder, not in time. And he's going to lose his head. Mike Joe's going to land a really nice impale, but it's way too late to save anyone. He's going to immediately go invis and try to get the hell out of here in the back end. There's someone in this imprisonment. It's Miracle. He's going to try to ulti out of here. Infernal Blade, the spin. His ultimate is holding for right now, but it's not going to hold forever, especially when another call comes in from Shotcho. The ultra kill for the Axe, and they're looking at maybe a fifth. Mind Control is pure physical. They don't do anything but physical damage, so these items are getting extra value. Like the extra armor from Blade Mail is just gonna be that much better. And Kuroki decides it's a good idea to teleport up towards the top lane. Probably not so. He's going to get his head chopped off. It's a pretty easy keeper of the light kill there. But
most decisions that you make day to day that end.
This is completely Shotch though, is gonna hit with the Demonic Purge, but he's kind of okay taking this as long as no one else on the team is. Seedoy is being focused down kind of, but he's ignoring all of that with the heals on him. He's just not losing HP, and now the chaotic offering drops onto four heroes, and they're all gonna hit with the Eclipse as well. That's two down immediately. Miracle's in the middle of things, but again, his ultimate's not gonna hold. He'll get spun down, and someone else is in the bubble. That's my Matama man. Sunder will actually end up killing the Doom, but it's not gonna save his own life. Ursa's back in. He immediately gets taunted by Shotch though. Again, the Axe play impeccable. Double kill. Kuroki's still alive. Buyback here on the Terror Blade. But Seedoy, he is going to get pushed right back into a spin onto Kuroki. Is that enough damage? Kuroki not going straight to his fountain, will get spun down. I think could have otherwise made it. And now Seedoy just buying items from the enemy base along with the OD.
These teams are in the regional qualifiers for Europe for Boston Major. That is coming up very shortly. So this could really set the tone for what we're going to see next week.
They went into the base through mid and jumped to the Nyx Assassin. You never see that one coming if you're Liquid. Kuroki's gonna try to Blinding Light and leave, but there's only leaving in a body bag. They walked in mid, there was no detection with the smoke, and
Major fight, I think. They've got two big ultimates on flip side, no Doom available. We'll see what Liquid can do about it.
Oh, they called the Nyx Assassin and almost kill him off the Eclipse. He's gonna not quite die, but he's gonna lose his head, so he's real dead now. And then there's the Chaotic Offering onto two heroes, but Tama Man's down to like 1 HP immediately. He's gonna Sundra, but even then, not gaining enough damage. Is gonna go down in Miracle as well. Triple kill for Shotch though. He deserves every single one of those. Only the Keeper survives. They take down the OD. Like, he has the Ags, he has the gem, but it's not even the right time to take this fight, but there is no other time they could possibly take this fight. Shotch's gonna kinda get jumped in the backside, but someone more relevant is gonna be Miracle. Ursa, almost dead. One more shot is all they need. And they will take him down, and they kill off the Terror Blade, and they Chaotic Offering the Fountain, because why not, and the Eclipse. Okay, I think Flipside at this point are just showing off because they can. They smashed Liquid in this third game, and they're moving on.
And that is going to be it for this best of three. 2-1 is Flipside.